I got black, I got white, what you want? Hop up in the ghost and I put in the fan, is it recording? I got black, I got white, what you want? Hop outside a ghost and hop up in the fan, I know I'm about to blow, when you done? They try to take my floor, I take their ass for ransom. My name is RX, and I'm Depop famous. Recently, I was scrolling through IG. I saw this post on Depop pretty much saying, how do you become famous on it? Because I'm trying to make some money. So I checked the comments and I realized that a lot of y'all are actually really thirsty to be featured and you really want to make some money on Depop. So that's what I'm here for. I'm here to tell you that. So don't fret. Little background about Depop if you didn't know. Depop is a selling medium slash app. Download it right now if you haven't, especially if you sell stuff, regardless of what it is. They're an app based out of London, but they also have offices in, I believe, Milan, New York City, as well as LA. I've actually been to the LA Depop space and it's pretty dope. It's like a little studio. You can like take a couple flicks with your friends. They have like some setups and stuff, a bunch of hipster ass people, hipster ass clothes, but nah, it was really chill. I went, it was like an event teaching you how to screen print or whatever. I stopped by and I was like, damn, this is a really cool office space, really cool environment. And no, if you're wondering, you can't just show up at the store and ask them to get featured. It doesn't work like that. Not that I tried or anything, but it was basically founded in 2011, so it's fairly new. And I recently just caught wind of it. I downloaded it exactly 1 year ago. And I was actually featured after just like a few weeks of being on it. It's gotten a lot bigger. It's up there with like Grailed and like eBay and what's the other one? Fuck, Postmates? No, wait, what? Nah, Poshmark. Poshmark. Not Postmates, what the fuck? I joined exactly 1 year ago under my username, Rexy2Sexy, at Rexy2Sexy, you know what I'm saying? Follow me if you haven't. If you have a Depop, follow me. Check out my stuff. I got a bunch of cool shit. In other selling mediums, you know, your items are at the forefront. You're like, all your materialistic stuff, it's just there. And you're just like listing them. There's no soul, it's just an item and a price. But on Depop, you have the ability to kind of like create a theme. It's very Instagram-esque. Like I actually have like double the followers on Depop than I do on my actual Instagram. Followers on me shit in any sort of social media, regardless of what it is, followers don't mean shit. But in terms of Depop and as a selling medium, kind of means something. You know what I mean? Like the more followers you have, the more traffic you get. Due to that, you know what I mean, you have a higher chance of selling, you have a higher chance of someone seeing something that they really fuck with and they're just like, yo, I need to buy that. That's essentially what we're trying to do here. We're trying to get you sales, we're trying to get you a bunch of new followers, get you featured and get more exposure to your page so you can start making some money, you know, regardless, like I said, of what it is, whether you're reselling something or if it's some old shit you found in the closet, you know what I mean, that you think is pretty hip and someone else would want it. Anything that you normally just bring it to a Goodwill or something and just give away, you know, you can make a couple bucks on it on Depop because that's just the wave right now. Having a feed of items and adding some personality to that feed is a big part of what will make you popular on Depop. And that segues into my first tip. Tip number one to getting featured on Depop is pretty much to have a theme for your posts. Depop is a very visual app, you know what I mean? Just like Instagram. So you're gonna wanna have to portray your clothes or whatever it is you're selling and kind of create like a underlying theme on your page for the Depop moderators to really see it and actually like be interested and be like, oh, like they actually put in a lot of work on their page. So let me go ahead and feature them. If you can invest in some sort of photography, lighting kit, you know what I mean, little backdrop, anything, like if you have the money, go ahead and do it. It makes it more convenient for you to just flick a couple shots of your clothes, you know what I mean, whatever makes it easier, as long as it's clean. Plain backgrounds do best, plain white, plain black. I actually did plain white. Actually, you could do what I did, my cheap ass. But right before I got featured, what I did was I got a roll of like poster paper that you get like from elementary school, you know, and you used to like draw and shit on it. Anyways, I got a roll of that. I put it on top of my fridge, and then I rolled it down like a red carpet down my kitchen, and then I taped it down so it wouldn't move. Turned on the kitchen lights, you know what I mean? Kitchen had the best lighting because it had like a little chandelier on top and everything. Turned on all the fucking lights in the kitchen, and yeah, I pretty much just went to town, you know what I mean, with this little personal backdrop I had. It didn't cost me shit. I found that stuff in the closet, you know what I mean? The pictures came out nice. Like, some pictures, they actually look like pretty clean. Personal favorites of like pages I've seen, basically I see people take a lot of their pictures on grass or like synthetic turf. That looks super clean, you know what I mean? And you get the, if you do take it outside, you get the daytime sunlight. That's probably like the best lighting you can get for the clothes. I actually have an example right here. Let me show you. Excuse my messy ass room, but hey, shout out to Funko game. Anyways, I found this fire ass North Face jacket. It's going for a lot right now. I got it for a steal. I'll probably make another video on this because like this was a finesse. But anyways, I got this and I'm trying to put it up on Depop. But as you can see, this is probably the cheapest solution. You know what I mean? These little command hooks. Just buy a couple, go to Target, cost like $5, and just put it against a white background. You know what I mean? This is my room. It's a lot better than just like taking pictures of your clothes in the closet. As you can see, my closet right there, like just taking flicks there, it looks ugly. But like, as you can see, against a white background, looks pretty clean. Open the window up and get some lighting. There you have it. So, Depop tip number two, captions and hashtags. Very, very important. You definitely need to utilize hashtags and the correct hashtags, okay? There's nothing worse than looking up like hashtag Supreme hat, and then all that comes up is fucking like shirts and everything because people don't know how to hashtag correctly, or they're just trying to get more looks on their page. Like, no one's gonna buy a random shirt that you put up if they're looking for specifically a Supreme hat. So just make sure you make your hashtags exact, you know what I mean? Like, don't put random shit, okay? I've fallen victim to that, but I've learned my lesson, you know what I mean? Include the condition it's in on an out of a 10 scale, you know, 9 out of 10, 8 out of 10. But don't be saying it's 9 out of 10 or 8 out of 10 if you got fucking doo-doo stains on your clothes. I mean, you gotta be honest about that stuff. And in terms of captioning, you should definitely include the dimensions of yourself and how the clothes pretty much fit you. If someone's gonna see an item that they really like, but it's like at a size bigger than theirs, they don't know if it's shrunk or if it fits small. So you definitely gotta list that if you wanna increase your sales. You gotta kinda tend to the customers and just kinda give them all the information you got. So if it's true to size, say it's true to size. If it's a little baggy, say if it's a little baggy, you know what I mean? You don't wanna end up like selling something and then having them return it just cause like the sizing was wrong. Like that, I've had that happen to me and it's pain in the ass. So I always make sure to really list the size so that I could just tell them next time, like, yo, you read my fucking description. You know that shit is tight as fuck. You know it's small. I can't wear it anymore. That's why I'm selling it. So
don't come at me with that bullshit trying to return it.
So tip number three, definitely follow a niche. Depop tends to categorize you. If you have mostly like retro vintage clothes, then you have to stick to that kind of niche, you know. They want to see that because it's easier to for them to categorize you and put you in a section in terms of the explore pages. Pick a theme and then stick to it. Like if you have mostly vintage clothes, stick to a vintage theme. If you have mostly sport clothes, stick to a sports theme. If you sell sex toys, stick to a wait, do they sell sex toys on Depop? Oh, okay then. Anyways.
Yeah, basically just pick one, stick to it, and it'll be easier for the moderators to categorize you and put you in a section on the explore page. Tip number four, and I cannot stress this enough, definitely have other people wear your clothes. Whoever it may be, if it's your mom, your brother, your sister, you know, your dog, just get anyone, even yourself, and just like, if you can, just put a self timer down and take pictures with the clothes on. Because like I said earlier, customers want to see and compare how the item would look on their body. So you're just pretty much trying to minimize any returns. Like if the clothes you're selling are used and you've already worn them before, shit, attach a picture of you wearing it, or just take a picture of you wearing it again, you know what I mean? Like, it'll only boost your sales from there. And extra points if you could add your dimensions, like your height, your weight and everything, and then the size of the item you're wearing, just so they could kind of compare to their own body dimensions and body proportions. Tip number five, the last tip I got, basically when they asked to feature me, they sent me a DM, and there's actually a few people. I can't really find the messages now because this was a while back. They pretty much messaged me saying, yo, we want you to be on the feature page, your explore page, we really dig it, if that's okay with you, blah blah blah. So yeah, they shot me a DM, and then I checked their profile, and they're pretty much the moderators of Depop. Like, they have their own pages, they sell their own shit, you know, they have a bunch of shit, bunch of sales. But if you look up on Depop on the search bar and look up from Depop, the words from Depop, the profiles of all the mods will pop up. Because I guess that's just their usernames, like John from Depop, William from Depop, you know what I mean? You could definitely ask them if you're worthy for a feature. They're definitely gonna see you, and just kind of bring light to your page by messaging them. And don't get mad if they don't reply or see it, because come on, they're probably super busy, but it's worth a shot. And I remember when I first started off, I was actually like talking back and forth with a lot of the moderators, because back then it wasn't as popular of an app. It was big, but it wasn't as popular as it is now. Kind of had time to talk to me, and I genuinely asked. I was like, yo, what can I do to get featured? But instead of just asking him straight up to get featured, kind of imply and be like, I want to get featured sometime in the future, so what are some tips you as a moderator could give me? You know what I mean? So easy money. That's all it is, easy money. You know what I mean? And you'll be getting more sales. Yeah, that's pretty much it from me. That's a daily prescription. I hope all you guys can get featured. Comment down below what your Depop name is. I'll go check out your page. Go buy my shit. You know what I mean? It's RX from the Daily Prescription. We out.